Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part four of solving absolute value inequalities, and we do these four inequalities on this video. So here we have 5 minus absolute value of x is greater than 2. The first thing we want to do is isolate the absolute value sign here, right? So I want to get rid of this minus 5. So that's the first thing I'm going to do. I'm going to subtract 5 from both sides of the inequality. And when you do that, be careful. You have a minus sign in front of that absolute value sign. So I have a negative the absolute value of x is greater than, right? And what's 2 minus 5? That's negative 3. So I haven't isolated the absolute value sign yet. So if you have a minus sign in front of it, remember that's the same thing as a negative 1. So what you could do is multiply or divide both sides of the inequality by negative 1 to get rid of that negative sign here. So a lot of people like doing it with division, so I'm going to go ahead and do it as division. So I'm going to think of this as a negative 1, and I'm going to divide both sides by negative 1. Now remember what happens when you multiply or divide by a negative? That switches directions. So over on the left side, my negative ones cancel, and now I have isolated that absolute value of x. So I've got absolute value of x is less than, and on the right-hand side, negative 3 over negative 1. So now I've got it in the form of an absolute value of something, right, of the stuff is less than a positive number. All right, so then this is the easy part. We did this in the very problems like this in the very first video on absolute value inequalities. What's inside is just an x, so it's just in between negative 3 and positive 3. So there's our solution right off the bat, and an interval notation that gives us between negative 3 and positive 3. If we're going to graph it, it would look like this, in between negative 3 and positive 3. And of course, yes, I do have to say like what these little tick marks stand for. Right? And then what you could do is plug a number in. So you could plug in 2 and make sure that if you plug it in for x, this inequality is going to be true. Or you can plug in negative 2, or you can plug in negative 1, or any fraction. I'm going to skip the checks because I want to go over the different special cases now that come up with absolute values inequalities. Here's the first one. Absolute value of 3x plus 1 is less than or equal to 0. Okay, notice this is not a positive number. So when we first defined how to solve these absolute value equations with less than, this was a positive number. 0 is not a positive number. So let's think about what this really is saying. It's really saying the absolute value of 3x plus 1 is either less than 0 or it's actually equal to 0. That's really what this is saying when you see the less than or equal to symbol. Right, now let's look at this first part. Could it be that you take the absolute value of something and you get something less than 0? That's absolutely impossible because when you take the absolute value of something, it's positive. So, absolute value is never less than 0. That's impossible. So, there's no way you're going to be able to solve that one. So, if you have less than or equal to 0, what we really are going to do is just solve this equation. The absolute value of x plus 1 can actually be equal to 0. And when it's equal to 0, there's only one way that's going to happen. The stuff inside here has to equal 0. So we end up just solving 3x plus 1 equals 0. Remember when it's a positive number, you say either it's like, if this was a 2, you'd write either 3x plus 1 is 2 or it's equal to negative 2, but not with 0. Because the opposite of 0 is still 0. So I end up just solving this equation here. And I just have one number for my solution. It's negative one-third. That is the solution to this problem. There's only one number that works in this inequality. Now, you could generalize this and say, well, any time you have something of this form, some stuff less than or equal to zero, you're just going to solve the equation that that stuff has to equal to zero if you want. I don't really memorize it, but that's what you ended up doing, right? What did we end up doing? The final analysis, whatever was in here, the only thing we were able to solve was 3x plus 1 equals 0. But if you reason it out, think about it, you'll come to that conclusion anyway. Right, here's another tricky one. So I haven't isolated the absolute value sign yet, so I'm going to subtract 4 from both sides to do that. And that gives me the absolute value of 4x minus 5 is less than 0. Okay. All right, here we have it again. Can you have the absolute value of something be less than 0? Remember, absolute value is a distance. It can't be less than 0. So this is just no solution. You're done. You can never have the absolute value of something be less than 0. So, you could write your solution set like that. So you simply cannot have the absolute value less than 0. So you go ahead and try solving this, but when you check it, nothing in the world is ever going to work. So again, you can generalize it if you want and remember it, that any time you have the absolute value of some stuff less than 0, the solution is going to be the null set, no solution. That's up to you. But again, I just reason it out each time instead of remembering all these little cases. Here's one more. I've isolated the absolute value. It says the absolute value of 2x plus 7 is less than or equal to negative 2. Here we are. Here we go again. Is it possible to have the absolute value of something less than or equal to negative 2? No, because this has to always be positive. Same reasoning as that it can't be less than 0. So this also has no solution. So again, you could generalize if you want and say, well, anytime I have some stuff less than or equal to some negative number, so I'm going to write that as negative k, where k is a positive number. Okay, so if you're really taking the opposite of a positive number, this ends up being a negative number, then there's going to be no solution. But again, I don't recommend memorizing this at all. You just have to look at each problem and think before you just start working it out. So most of the problems that we've worked with are going to be in the form where you will have a positive number over here, k. So here's in general, right, what we do. If we have some stuff less than a positive number, we take the stuff out of the absolute value and put it in between negative k and k. If it's less than or equal to it, we just use the less than or equal to symbols. And when k is a negative number or zero, then think about it and try to figure out the solution, which were the special cases we did in this video. All right, so on to the next video. To solve absolute value inequalities with greater than or greater than or equal problems. So in the next videos, we'll be doing problems like absolute value of 2x plus 1 is greater than or equal to, let's say, 5. We'll be doing some problems like this in the next few videos. So far we've only covered how to do problems with less than or less than or equal. Now we're going to move on to what if it's greater than or greater than or equal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.